Hey, it's Fran again. And last week I did a video on this great 8-inch plasma ball, and lots of comments, some of them talking about some cool things you can do with plasma bulbs that I didn't really think about just because I was just so enamored with the whole effect. But a lot of people said, well, you know, other YouTubers have done videos on the smaller versions of these plasma balls, and turns out they're actually quite dangerous. So, of course, I had to buy one of those too. I got one of the 3-inch balls. Yep. One of the things about this, people noted, and I just now really noticed, that when you do this and touch the plasma ball and you bring an arc up to your finger, it does produce ozone. In fact, I can, if I'm close to the ball when I'm doing this, I can smell the sort of sweet, summery, after-rain smell of ozone. But that only happens when you're actually touching the globe. Yeah, sort of a sweet, sweet smell. Yeah, it doesn't really have the sweet smell when you're not actually touching it. All right. But that's one effect. Another thing is that they said that these smaller globes can put out some pretty dangerous UV. Now, I've got my UV meter, so I'm gonna use my UV meter, and this is near and far UV, so UVA and B. I'm not putting this up against the globe because it would just draw an arc and probably blow up my meter. Yeah, from this I'm getting just maybe just the lowest trace reading, just barely blips. Yeah, it's very, very slight. I mean, yeah, it just barely reads. I mean, if I take this over to the window, you know, even with the cloudy overcast, I'm probably getting about 300 units on this. Okay, yes, you're over 100, and that's only like, that's completely overcast outside. So that's really what we're talking about as far as UV. And again, this is the reading through my ultraviolet filter that I have on the window. So it's like it's barely reading maybe 5 microwatts peak. Let's see. Let me get on this smaller one. All right, we got, this is a USB powered, but that's fine because I've got 5-volt supplies. All right. Some people did note too, they said, oh, you know, you're supposed to have a little like a plastic hemisphere to put on the back of this thing. No, I didn't get anything like that. I think those are probably for the ones that people bought years ago. Now this one, this little 3-inch, of course I'm in low light here, but I see a little circuit board in there, but this is really cheap. It's 5 volts, so let's see, like a little 5 volt supply. I don't know how much current this is going to require, but 1.5 amps should be enough for this little ball, although this big one takes a 10 watt supply. Now, I'm going to say right off the bat that I have UV filtering lenses on my glasses. It's one of the things I get on all my glasses is UV AB filters, so I'm not going to burn my retinas looking into this. So let's see here, and on it goes. Oof, there we go. Let's see here, get the UV. All right. Yeah, this one, again, not a lot of UV, a little bit as to be expected with any kind of high voltage, but very minimal. It's really just less than 5 microwatts of UV. And again, that's A and B. So, yeah, no UV from this one, but definitely a lot more neon. This is almost pure orange. And you notice that the wattage is much lower, so the little tendrils we're getting on this one are very, very minuscule. Actually, I gotta be honest, I like this little one. It's pretty cool. But yeah, the orange indicates that this is probably mostly neon. Yep. Let me see if I can smell any ozone on this. No, I don't smell the ozone. So my guess is that the voltage, obviously the current is much less, but the voltage is probably lower on this little ball than it is on the big ball. The big ball, I don't know. I don't have a high voltage meter, but I would estimate that it's, you know, somewhere in the order of like 4,000 or 5,000 volts. this is probably in the order of maybe, you know, I don't know, maybe 1,500, 2,000 volts maybe. But yeah, no sound, no smell of ozone, and definitely no dangerous gases. I think the video, I'll link it in the description, but the video that the other YouTuber did a spectrographic analysis of his high UV little lamp, and had a lot of nitrogen in it, nitrogen argon, and that's pretty dangerous mixture. Just really cheap gas. It's very readily available for making fluorescent lamps, you know, with fluorescent you've got a phosphor in there, and also some the glass is usually made of a special type of glass that's UV filtering, so you don't get the, you know, gushing UV rays out of the fluorescent bulbs. You get a little bit of the near UV, not the far UV. But this is clearly done to be safe. Seems to be mostly neon. A little bit of argon in there. I can see, you know, the little purplish at the, you know, towards the core, and that's obviously where the little bit of UV is coming from. But it's very minuscule. But it's very pretty. I gotta say. I like this little one. I like this little guy a lot. But at least the ones that they're selling at the Franklin Institute are not dangerous for emissions. But there are some things I want to try. People said you should get a bulb and put it near the field. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to grab a lamp here. So I've got compact fluorescent here, and I'm not going to hold it by the base because, you know, you've got a high voltage transformer in there, and there's a chance that if you energize this, you could get high voltage on, you know, on the other side. But let's see. Let's see if this works. And again, there's very little ultraviolet, so it's fluorescing ever so slightly. If I make contact, yeah, there we go. But you really got to make contact to draw the current. Put it behind here, you can see where it's drawing the current, and this is being energized by a pretty strong electrical field around the plasma ball from the high voltage, and some of that is also ultraviolet. Like I said, it's a tiny little bit of UV, but there's probably enough far UV, even though it's like in the fractions of a microwatt, to fluoresce a little bit, but largely what we're seeing here is really just the electrical field stimulating the gas inside of the fluorescent tube. Let's compare here. Ooh, they're fighting each other a little bit. Yeah. Oh yeah. See, that's definitely got a much stronger field here on the big one. Yeah, look at that. Wah, wah, wah. Pretty cool. Pretty cool. This would probably be more impressive with like a big tube. Not too much. I mean, it's not really glowing. Of course, see, this is in circuit, so it's probably got an inductive load on it. So it's glowing a little bit. Now I do have a little bit of daylight, very slight. It's hardly stimulating the gas in the big tube. Yeah. Oh, science! Friggin' science, man. Love it. Okay. There's one more thing that I want to try. Do not try this one at home. Turn this off here. Turn this little guy. I don't even like this little guy. Hello! Hello! It's got the audio trigger, so I guess... Hello! Plasma ball! So if you do, you can sit it on, I guess, sit it, you know, near a speaker, and as the beat would go, it would flash. But I don't think that's really cool, because if you modulate the plasma, it just isn't impressive. It's really got to be running full tilt and to animate. So anyway, but yeah, one more thing I want to try with this ball that you should not try at home. It's going to require a little bit of foil. So let me go grab that. This is dangerous time. I'm going to get some aluminum foil. And this is going to... basically what I'm doing is I'm putting a conductor on this. And this is basically turning this into a really big capacitor. A very inefficient one. But, you know, the gas inside of the sphere is going to be... You could consider that dielectric, like an air gap capacitor, and then this is going to be one of the plates, the other plate being the electrode that's in there. And I very dangerously have grounded a screwdriver. All right, so let's see here. Hopefully this won't blow up. Perf. All right, let's see what this is. Whoa. I just blew out my monitor there with an emission. Obviously, a burst of RF there. Oh, yep. I keep blowing out my monitor. It keeps resetting. Youch! Beep. So, yeah, you do not want to do this. And this is also what happened to me when I was finishing up that video that I did on this big ball, because I had my finger on the plasma ball and I grabbed over and touched the zoom on the camera on the top, and there was the button on the top. It's, you know, it's close to this the steel frame of the camera, and when I pushed the button down, my finger got close enough to the steel frame that I pulled an arc about the same length as what we got here. And yeah, it felt exactly like this. Here. Yep, that's what it felt like. So that's the danger. But I mean, we're talking low currents here. Obviously, I mean, I didn't die. I didn't get burnt. It just hurt like hell. because, I mean, we're talking very high voltages, very low current, you know, this is a thing. So, but, you know, I've gotten jolted by thousands of volts before, and lived to tell the tale. It's not about, you know, as far as being dangerous, it's not about the voltage, it's about the current. It's all about the current. So, but yeah, I thought you'd enjoy that. But yeah, I love these guys, and the little one is so cute. I'm gonna put that in my office because it's not really emitting any dangerous UV. So they got the, it's mostly neon, a little bit of argon. So yeah, at least these ones they sell at the Franklin Institute, they have definitely vetted them. Although with all these high voltage things, you definitely want to make sure that if you're playing with them that you are not grounded. If you're standing barefoot on a stone or cement floor and you touch the globe, you're going to regret it. You're definitely going to regret it. But, you know, if you've got insulation, you've got rubber-soled shoes, you're not grounding yourself, you won't pull current. And they are fun. They're definitely fun. All right. Well, thanks for watching. Thanks too to everyone down on the Patreon, making all these videos possible. Thank you, thank you, thank you, everyone on the Patreon. Thanks too to everyone who's tossing in a little in the pot for my zero-G flight in September. That's just, I'm so, so happy because so many of you, hundreds of people have chipped in to make that flight a reality, and I will not let you down. It's going to be a lot of fun, and I am going to share 100% of it with you. All right. Well, I'm Fran. I'll be back in the lab with something else, you know, guaranteed to be fun. Maybe a little dangerous, you know, a little dangerous. But, you know, always fun. And, you know, the most fun things in life are a little dangerous. That's just the fact. All right. I'm Fran. I'll see you back here real soon. Bye! Berserk in my lab. It's where I work. I'm Fran.